Namaskar and a very warm welcome to this edition of the Phone-In program. I'm Nidhi Kumar and you're watching India Science. 39,361 fresh corona cases have been lower than yesterday's count. About 40 crore people in the country are still vulnerable. The Sero survey has showed, highlighting that about 67% of India's population has developed antibodies. In this Phone-In program, it is our endeavor and effort here on India Science to encourage you to go and take that vaccination shot. We take your queries live and we take your questions live, and we have experts joining in to answer all your queries. So today we're joined by Dr. Naval K. Vikram, Professor, Metabolic Research Group, Department of Medicine, All India Institute of Medical Sciences. Many thanks for joining us today. Namaste and welcome to the program, sir.
Namaste.
Doctor, before we start taking the questions from our viewers, please tell us about the Delta variant and the Delta Plus variant as you look at this K417N mutation, and why is this so transmissible?
See, this Delta is one of the variant which has was seen, started from India, but now it is all over the world. So this is a variant of concern. So why it is a variant of concern? Because there is some indication that this may be more easily transmissible to other people as compared to the earlier variants, which have been given different names as Alpha, Beta, Gamma, and this is the Delta. And second is that there is some fear that this may cause a more severe disease. And the third concern is that this may escape the neutralizing antibodies, which are generated by, say, vaccination or after an infection. So this may escape some of those phenomena and still cause a disease. However, and the Delta Plus is another mutation which is seen in the Delta virus, which has been designated as B1.617.2, which is the technical name given to that anyway. So Delta Plus is, it has another mutation, K417N. So this is a mutation which is seen in the Beta variant and which is now seen in the Delta Plus, because Delta Plus has both the Delta mutation as well as the Beta. So that's been given Delta Plus, and the Beta variant was one in South Africa, which was associated with increased number of deaths. So that is why it is a concern right now that if the Delta Plus variant becomes very common, then will it lead to increase in the severity of disease? However, we still have very limited data as to the severity of disease that it's going to cause, or if it's really a variant of concern.
Thank you so much, sir. We're now joined by our first caller for today, Geeta Mishra from Mumbai. Namaste. Welcome to India Science. Please ask your question, Geeta ji.
Hello, ma'am. This is Geeta Mishra from Mumbai. My question is, as we speak, children's trials are going on. What is the current status and how soon can we see children vaccinated?
Okay. The vaccination in children. So currently in our country, the vaccination trials are going on with several vaccines. One is the Covaxin, which is the Indian-made vaccine. The trial has, the second dose has been given to 6 to 12-year-olds, and the 2 to 6-year-olds also, the trial is going on. So the results we may get possibly by September, October. Then we'll be knowing about how effective they are in this age group. The second vaccine is the Zydus vaccine, which is has completed its trial, and that is in the 12 to 17-year-old age group. So in that age group, they have completed the trials. In about, say, 4 to 6 weeks, possibly we will have the results and also possibly approval of that vaccine for children. And above 18 years of age, all the vaccines are anyway approved. And Pfizer is the another vaccine which has not yet come to India, which is an mRNA-based vaccine. It is approved in the West, in the United States and other European countries. There it is being given to children above 12 years of age. It is approved. And the other vaccine, Moderna, that also, the trial has been done from 12 to 17 years, and it has been approved by the European Medical Agency for children 12 to 17 years. However, these vaccines are still not available in India, and in India we don't have any approval right now for use of these vaccines below 18 years of age. And let's hope in the next 1 or 2 months, if we get these vaccines, the other vaccines which are there in other countries, and the data which we have from our own population, and after that probably they will get an emergency approval.
Thank you, Doctor. Very heartening news indeed that children are being vaccinated as far as the trials are on, and we will soon see children get the vaccination all across India. So that is very heartening news for all of us today. Meanwhile, we are joined by our second caller, Shekhar Mathurji. He joins us from Surat. Namaste, Shekharji. Please ask your question.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir. Sir, my question is, I am suffering from hemophilia. Can I get the vaccine shot?
Of course. It depends what is the severity of your hemophilia. That is, the severity of hemophilia is based on the factor 8 levels. So, the activity of factor 8 levels, what percentage it is. See, if you do not have, generally severe hemophiliac patients, patients suffering from hemophilia, they develop spontaneous bleeding into joints and body spaces. If you are not having any such problem, that you are not developing spontaneous bleeding frequently and requiring factor 8 replacement, then it can be given. And the usual needle which is used is a 23 gauge, which is a thin needle. And the injection, you can get the vaccine. My friends who are suffering from hemophilia also have been given the vaccine. The only precaution one has to take is that I think you have to keep the injection site pressed for a little while, maybe 5-10 minutes, so that a hematoma, collection of blood, doesn't happen there. You can get the shot.
Thank you so much, and I hope that answers your question. Meanwhile, we are joined by yet another caller, Ms. Kajal, joining us now from Allahabad. Namaste, Kajal ji. Please ask your question.
Hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. This is Kajal from Allahabad. Sir, my question is that one of my elderly relative is suffering from uncontrolled diabetes and heart disease and kidney disease as well. So, should she get vaccinated?
Yes. Every elderly individual, and particularly those suffering from comorbidities, they should get vaccinated, because if they contract the disease, then the disease is more likely to have a severe form in them. So they should get the disease, they should get the vaccine shot, definitely. But because in elderly and with more number of diseases together, so this person is likely to be on several medications. And in some of these medications could be blood thinners. So precaution should be taken in that situation, that if the person is on blood thinners, then a special care has to be taken. We need to inform the vaccine center that this is the situation, and maybe a dose of the blood thinner can be withheld for 24 to 48 hours before the vaccine, and then subsequently it can be started. And if the person is a diabetic, it's better to have a good control of the diabetes before going for the vaccine. Because if other coexisting diseases are not well controlled, that is, diabetes is not well controlled, patient person is having some active CAD, like symptomatic coronary artery disease or heart failure or active kidney problem which is requiring immediate management. So these kind of patients should first take care of or stabilize the underlying disease condition, and then they should get the vaccine shot. They should get. Every elderly with comorbidities should get.
Thank you so much for that insight. And now we're joined by Shikha from Nagpur. Namaste, Shikha ji. Please ask your question.
Hello, this is Shikha from Nagpur. Sir,
My question is, should pregnant and lactating women get vaccinated for COVID-19?
Two questions also, yes, on the now. Same, doctor. I'll add to this. There is a sub-question on the YouTube also that are lactating mothers who have taken the first shot and are not able to take the second shot in severe zone as far as getting the disease is concerned, should there be the onset of the third wave? How careful and how concerned should we be?
Okay, the first question is, should pregnant and lactating women get the shot? As of July, the government of India has approved the COVID vaccination, both vaccines which are available for pregnant women. And now they can get it at any stage of pregnancy. The reason for this is if a pregnant woman contracts the disease, then the chances of that having a severe disease may be slightly higher. And if she develops a severe disease, both the life of the mother and the child, fetus, is at risk. So there are two lives at risk. And that is why the vaccination has been approved as of this month. But the trials in pregnant women have not been that many. And that is the reason it is approved. But it has to be clearly counseled. The pregnant woman should be counseled before that. These are the risks of having the disease, and these are the possible problems or possible side effects of vaccine. So based on that, they should be well informed, and then the vaccine can be given. Lactating women definitely can take the vaccine, and those who have taken just one vaccine, they should get the second vaccine, because again, if we don't know about the third wave, whether when it is coming or how severe it is likely to be. But if there is a surge, increase in the number of cases, partially vaccinated or unvaccinated individuals are definitely at risk of developing the disease. They're possibly more likely to be a more serious disease. So that is why they should get the vaccine.
Thank you so much for that. And now we're joined by another caller from Gwalior. Joining us is Mr. Sanjeev. Namaste, Sanjeev ji. Please ask your question.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir. Sir, my question is, I had COVID-19 infection a week after my first dose of vaccine. Should I get the second dose at all? If yes, then when?
Yes, yes. Individuals who have had COVID disease, they also should get vaccinated. And if after your first dose you have developed COVID, then after recovery, once you have recovered completely, then you can get the vaccine. Initially, it was out of a period of 4 to 8 weeks, but now the Government of India guidelines say that after recovery, 3 months after recovery, you can get your second vaccine shot. And yes, vaccine is important even in those who have had the disease. Because currently, we don't know if you have had the disease, how long the antibodies which are developed after the infection are likely to remain so. That is why if you get a vaccine shot, that would be a good idea. But to prevent infection from the further oncoming waves and newer variants.
Thank you for that. Joining us now is yet another caller. Amita joins us from Mumbai. Yes, Amita, namaste. Welcome to India Science. Please ask your question.
Namaste, ma'am. Hi, sir.
Hi.
Sir, I had COVID-19 disease and my antibody levels are quite high. So do I need to get vaccinated?
Yes, yes. Even as I said earlier, even if you have had a COVID-19 disease and now you get your antibody levels, they are higher. So still in that situation, it's better to get vaccinated. And as I said, that after 3 months after recovery from COVID-19 disease, that would be the appropriate time to get your vaccine shot. Vaccine is basically to prevent future infections, because reinfection has also been seen in individuals who have already had a disease. Now, there's some news that one infection with one variant, and may people are having another infection, possibly by a different variant. So, vaccine still has to be taken.
Absolutely, and it is a must. So all of us should get vaccinated at the earliest, like doctor says. We're joined by someone from Kerala. Shweta joins us from Kerala. Namaste, Shweta. Please ask your question. We've lost the audio, doctor. Meanwhile, could you please clarify, as there are YouTube questions coming on, flashing in front of me, could you please clarify why people are going through long COVID and they're developing, some kind of clots or cardiac problems or even some kind of a stroke or paralysis, and some are also seeing fatal cases?
See, this infection is a new infection, and it is affecting every part of the body. And initially, it was thought that it is a short duration, but because of the infection, because of the very severe inflammation, because inflammation which happens is the main culprit. Virus comes to the body and it disappears within, say, 10 days in most of them, most of the patients. But it leaves behind a lot of inflammation, and inflammation is the one process which damages several organs, and this also may be responsible for developing blood clots. If the blood clot happens to be in the coronary artery, the person can have a heart attack. If the blood clot develops in the brain, the person can have a stroke. Or if the blood clot develops anywhere in any part of the body, the organ can be affected. So this is one reason, and some patients may continue to have the inflammation may be prolonged. Usually inflammation settles in a few weeks, but in some the inflammation goes on at a higher level for a very long time, and this is possibly the reason why it is these people may be having a prolonged COVID, which is because of ongoing COVID, inflammation, yes, involving different organs.
Thank you so much. We are now joined again by Shweta from Mumbai. Namaste, Akshita. Please ask your question.
Hello, sir. This is Akshita from Kerala. Sir, my question is that how long does the immunity last after the vaccination? And do I need to get a booster dose frequently?
I think that's a question many people nowadays are asking, that how long is the immunity going to last? Now, the data that is there on the Western population that we have, Indian data has yet to come. We need to see that for how long after vaccination we have the immunity. But the data coming from the Western population, it shows that the immunity may last somewhere ranging from about 8 to 9 months. Also, the antibody levels may be high. And then comes the concept of a booster dose, so which still is not clear. The exact duration when the booster dose is required, or is it required at all, that still is not clear. There is a trial about on Covaxin, which is trial is going on the need or the effect of a booster dose on individuals who have already received two doses of vaccine. So we will see the data in the few coming months, but as of now, it is not very clear. See, antibodies are the common way in which immunity is measured, but the immunity is also developed by the cell mediated immunity. The cells are there which are active against the offending organism. So that is something which is not very easily or readily measurable in every lab. Antibodies are easily measurable. That is why we talk about antibodies more frequently. But some indication is there that cell mediated immunity may last for a little longer than the antibody. So, more information is being generated, and over a period of time, we should know whether what is going to happen.
Sounds interesting. The data that you've shared with us just now, and data yet to come. We're all looking forward to that. Meanwhile, joining us from Chandigarh is Ms. Shobha. Namaste. Please ask your question, Shobha ji.
Hello. Sir, I hear that there are a lot of side effects after COVID vaccine. Is it safe to give vaccine to elderly people then?
Yes. There are some side effects because these are newer vaccines, and most common side effects are a person may have body aches, fatigue, headache, and some people may even develop a fever, which is usually a very self-limiting problem, which may last only for a day or two, and maybe at the most three days or so. And yes, these are the symptoms which can be easily taken care of by, let's say, paracetamol or Rocrosin, which is good enough. That can be given and the symptoms can be all right. But the benefit of vaccine is far greater than the risk of having these symptoms. Rarely some data is coming about some rare symptoms, rare adverse effects like formation of blood clots after giving vaccine, or developing a heart problem after giving a vaccine. But these have been so less, or let's say this, the incidence of these adverse effects are found to be almost similar as it may happen in the general population. And that is why millions and millions have been vaccinated and very few of these adverse effects have been seen. So definitely I would say the benefits far, far outweigh the risk of any adverse event. So yes, elderly also should be vaccinated because they are at increased risk of developing a severe disease.
Absolutely. And the side effects or effects, as you put very correctly, are negligible, doctor. Joining us now is Karthik from Delhi. Namaste, Karthik. Please ask your question.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir. Sir, hello. We are hearing a lot about new variants every day. Will the present vaccine protect me against the variants of coronavirus?
You see, coronavirus, it is inherent in its nature to mutate. Now, it will keep on mutating. So as we see that it started with a very virulent strain and gradually has come down to a milder strain. And it's just speculated that it may mutate about twice in a month. So newer variants will keep on happening. It's the nature of the virus. So it doesn't matter. These vaccines which are there as of now, they all are effective against the variants which are being seen so far. There is no indication, no clear data available to suggest that the variants which are occurring may escape the immunization or escape the neutralizing effect of vaccines. Even the Delta and Delta Plus, there is no clear indication that these are going to escape the vaccine. So that is why the variants will keep on coming. The vaccines which we have right now, we have multiple vaccines and more of them are coming. So it's better to get vaccinated. So the vaccine is going to protect against many of these variants. They are not going to do any harm.
Oh, thank you for that, doctor. We're joined by Archana Khanna from Meerut. Please ask your question, Archana. Welcome. Science.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir, my question is, if anybody is suffering from acute body pain or headache, is there any possibility for him to be a COVID positive?
Acute body pain and headache is maybe one of the symptoms of COVID disease. But see, if it is, then several other diseases also in the present situation where we have the rains in the most of the parts of the country. In such situations, these can be symptoms of many other diseases such as malaria, dengue, or other acute febrile, other viral illnesses. So just based on this, unlikely, very difficult to say that it could be a COVID-19. Yes, if there is a fever, if there is a possibility that the person has been exposed to somebody who's having the disease, then there is a chance. But otherwise, just based on these two, it's not possible. But if there is a suspicion, then one may get tested for COVID-19.
Absolutely, doctor. Question flashing now on our YouTube. I'd like to take that with you. People say that vaccines are linked to long-term health problems such as multiple sclerosis, diabetes, autism. Is this true? Please explain.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not, because these vaccines, the COVID vaccines, are very new. We do not have that long-term data to say that these vaccines are associated with any problems. So that is absolutely incorrect. And vaccines which are related to mutism or autism, sorry, this was one major myth which was with the measles vaccine. But that was proven to be absolutely false, and possibly this myth had led to many people refusing the measles vaccine. And we have seen there have been outbreak of measles in the Western population, where the generally these kind of infections don't occur. So there have been outbreaks of measles in Western populations also, primarily because of the refusal to take this vaccine.
Absolutely. We're joined by our last caller for today, Sameena from Delhi. She's joining us. Namaste, Sameena.
Hello. Hello, ma'am. I'm Sumaya. And my question is, I'm recovering from COVID in the hospital surrounded by critical patient. So that chance, can I catch it again?
Well, you have recovered from COVID.
Reinfection, basically.
Reinfection. So if you have had COVID in the past, you have recovered, the chances of getting an infection may still be there if you are exposed to a person who has a very high viral load. So chances of reinfection may be there, but the chances of you developing the disease again are very negligible, because infection can happen. Even those who are vaccinated can get infected, but the chances of them developing a disease or them developing a severe disease are very, very less. So reinfection can occur, but the possibility of disease is very less. Don't worry.
And on that note, I would like to thank you, Dr. Naval Vikramji, for joining us today. And with this is a wrap on this edition of This Phone-In. Do join us every Monday from 3 to 3:30 on India Science, and keep watching Question Hour on India Science. And in the end, I'd like to only say, all of you, vaccinate, 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 keep social distancing and wear a mask. On that note, many thanks for watching. Namaskar.